is that him showing up happens behind closed doors. There are some situations that the Lord will need to have the doors closed in order for him to show up.
Yes.
In essence, everybody can't see what the Lord's going to do for you. The door is closed and Jesus shows up. And when he comes, he doesn't address anybody but Thomas. He just says, put your hand right here. What I like about it is that the disciples who did believe didn't have a conniption fit trying to explain everything to the doubter. They just waited, and the Lord said, I got it. And when the Lord says he has it, let him have it.
Come on now, Pastor. That's right.
So he says, put your hand right here. And put your other hand right here. And what you miss, you know I got to give you a shout out. You miss it. You just missed it. Do me a favor. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, you missed it. Here it is. The text doesn't reveal that Thomas actually places his hand there. But the word that he suggests at the mere mention that Jesus says, put it there, is my Lord and my God. You missed your shouting moment. I don't have to touch it with my hand in order for me to believe it. I don't have to have it all together in order for me to believe it. Oh, I just got to be willing to have him extend it. Where you at? You thought you had to touch it. You thought that you had to actually do something else in order for him to have the victory come to you. No, the Lord just says, Thomas, if you're willing, I can do it. So I got a question. Are you really willing to ask the question that Thomas says? He's got courage. Young people today got courage. They say, yeah, I know. He'll fix it. Yeah, that's nice. But my situation is different. He fixed it for you, but you had both parents. I ain't got but one. He fixed it for you, but you got a job and a 401k. And he fixed it for you, and you retired, so you got an income. He fixed it for you and your son and your daughter ain't pregnant and they ain't in prison. They got their driver's license. He fixed it for you and you hadn't had to cry at night because of fear that somebody was going to misuse you and mishandle your body. You got it together. You, of course, you can believe because your situation doesn't look like mine. But Thomas says, because my situation is different, he got to do something different. And Jesus just says, whatever you want, I can handle it. And Thomas, I like it, you missed it again. He doesn't put his hand there. He just happens to get happy and see Jesus on the mere fact that Jesus is willing to do it. Can you see him? Just because he's willing to fix your situation, can you see him? Just because he shows up, just because he's present, just because he's willing to be there with you in the midst of your nastiness, he's willing to be present. Is that enough for you to say, Lord and God? That's real faith. I ain't putting my hand in it, but he is. I can see him. I got a question for you, and I'm done. The end of the chapter is important because it says this, that everything that's recorded in this book was recorded because it was necessary to show you that Jesus is the one. Don't miss this shout field moment. Everything you are currently dealing with is allowed by God's omniscient presence to help you come to believe that Jesus is the one. Yes. You and I truly miss a resurrection in the most necessary area of our life. We miss resurrection because we just think it's him getting up for the sins of the world. He also is able to resurrect your dead situations.
Yes.
And he wants to use them so that others might believe. So the question I have for you today, are you willing not to live through somebody else's relationship with the Lord? Are you really willing to get your own? Are you willing and courageous enough to ask what you really want to know? You really want to know, can he do it for you? And are you willing to wait until he shows up?
All right.
Now for those who already have seen him, are you willing to be still and let the Lord be the Lord? Just don't say nothing. Just be still. And my brothers and sisters, are all of us willing to understand that what we are currently in now is for somebody else to come to believe that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life? The real issue is, do you believe he can resurrect in you? Your current situation. Pastor, I thought it was early. It was on the third day morning that he was resurrected. But Thomas didn't get it until a week later. Everybody isn't going to get it on Easter. Sometimes it'll be a week late. But when Thomas gets it, he gives the cry of the disciple, my Lord and my God. I'm not sure what you need the Lord to resurrect today, but I'm clear it's something. And whatever it might be, my brother, my sister, it won't happen through the religious experiences of somebody else. It won't happen through the ritual that we go through that we call worship. It will happen when you are courageous enough to ask the real question. You're willing to express your doubt, then he can come in and give you deliverance.